welcome back to the channel. Today I'm doing a video requested by M. Ryson. I hope I said your name right. On Instagram. They asked me to do a video on overstocking and stocking requirements. And I've touched on this before, but I've not done an entire video on it. I've heard some people say that you should do 20 gallons per fish and then 10 gallons for every fish after, or some people say 20 gallons per fish in general, when it comes to goldfish anyway. I don't really go by either. I don't really have a set requirement that I go by. I probably go by the 20 more often than not. But it also depends on the size of the aquarium. Like the one behind me is 60 gallons and there are 4 fish in it. There's 2 arandas, a ryukin, and a fantail in that aquarium. And, you know, some people say there should only be 3 in the aquarium and there's 4. I think you can get away with adding one more in a tank like that. I have, and some people say that you stunt them and they won't grow to their full potential, and I haven't had that issue. They've grown a lot, and I also have really good filtration and oxygenation in the tank, which helps a lot as well. And I do not slack on my water changes. That is one thing that I do a lot. So, you know, water changes for me are weekly, 80%. I'm always on that and I always rinse my filters. So, you know, that also backs me up for overstocking. I also have another tank in my kitchen that looks just like that one. It's the same tank, but it's decorated differently and has different fish in it, of course. But, it has 3 butterflies, a black moor, and a fantail, and that's 5. And some people get a little judgy about that on my Instagram. Originally, it was stocked with 4, the same as this tank in here. However, I have 2 fantails, Eli and Ellie. Eli is in this aquarium, and Ellie is in the other. Ellie does not get along with my other fish. So she originally was with my Ronchu, but she didn't get along with them. She does not get along with the fish in this tank, and she does not get along with the fish in my 40-gallon breeder. So I didn't really have anywhere else to put Ellie, and so I put her in there. And so far she's doing okay, and I haven't had any issues. You also have to remember that that tank is used to having 5 fish in it because Beauty, my black Aranda, she used to be in there before she passed away, and so it's used to the load. I also have double filtration. The filter circulates 600 gallons per hour, same as this one back here, and there's also excellent oxygenation and the water changes are the same. So I can get away with that and the fish still grow and I haven't had any issues. Also for my 40-gallon breeder, it's excellent for 2 fish, but I have 3 in it currently. Lucy is my small ryukin. She's a short-tail ryukin, and she used to be in this tank before I put my fantail in there. However, she had some issues with buoyancy. Ryukins tend to have swim bladder issues because of their short, compact bodies, and that's pretty common, actually. She has trouble with deep water, and so I ended up moving her into this tank just to see if that would help her any, and she swims so much better now in the 40 breeder, and so I just left her. And it's done fine, and they're growing like crazy. I would not put more than 3 in a 40-gallon breeder. To me, anything smaller than a 40 is very strict to the 20-gallon rule. If it's a 20-gallon tank, then it should be 1 goldfish, period. If it's a 30-gallon tank, 1 fish. Unless you have, you know, like fry or, you know, small, very, very small goldfish, you could get away with a couple, but it would be their grow out tank, so to speak, and you would later have to move them to a larger tank. But one thing that drives me insane is on Instagram, I see a lot of keepers that have really pretty aquariums to the eye anyway. One in particular that I'm thinking of has a, I believe it's a 50 gallon tank. I think they've asked her this before, but I think it's a 50 gallon tank. Very, very similar to my Ronchu tank in the living room. And it has a little over, the last time I counted, there was 26 fish, goldfish, in that tank. That is completely ridiculous, and you should not do that. You know, a 50-gallon tank, you can get by. There's three fish in that currently, and they're doing fine. I could add one small fish and still be okay with my filters, but I probably won't do that. I'm happy with the way it looks right now, but that's just way too many fish. People think, you know, I get a lot of, she's a fairly popular Instagram goldfish keeper. And when people, you know, send me messages and ask me questions about their fish, why they're sick, or there's something wrong with their water quality, they throw that up to me a lot. You know, she has this many fish in this tank, why can't I? Well, first of all, on Instagram, you're just seeing the pictures of the aquarium. Yes, it looks nice, but she's not showing you what happens later on when the camera's off. You know, you're gonna have probably aggression with the fish because they're packed in a tight area. Her ammonia and nitrate, nitrite's probably going to be off the charts all the time. Her filter probably is not going to keep up with her cycle. She's going to have to do water changes pretty much every day in order to keep this going. And she also doesn't show you how many fish she loses, because it's quite often you will notice that one fish is no longer in the aquarium because it died. And then she keeps adding them back, and it drives me insane because you're not supposed to do that. You would think that she would, you know, at some point figure out that they're dying because she is not taking care of her fish. She is not doing what is best for the fish. She is very overstocked. So, you know, adding one or two more fish in a 60 gallon than is what is recommended, it's not going to be a super big deal than adding, you know, 10, 15, 20 fish in there. That's not something I would ever do. I would not ever add more than 5 fish in a 60 gallon tank. That's not happening. And I don't understand why people think that's okay. It drives me insane. But you have to think about as well, the water, the size of the tank has a lot to do with dilution. And when you have a smaller tank, there's not a lot of dilution that occurs because it's small. There's not a lot of surface area. The more fish that you pack into this aquarium, the less dilution there is. And the more quickly you're going to have spikes of ammonia and nitrate, nitrite. And, you know, the more issues you're going to have. So, you know, it's just, you have to be very, very careful with stocking your aquariums, because it will hurt you in the long run if you're not careful. So I hope that answered your question, and I hope y'all learned something. And stick around for new videos. I'm on a roll so far. So I'll see y'all next time.